Welcome back to this mini course on building vision applications with OpenVINO. In the previous video, we've seen how to look for a model in the OpenVINO model zoo, and we've used the Open Model Zoo downloader to get our face detection model. Now, let's use it. I'm at the Jupyter Notebook 4. Under the data directory, you can find images for one face, two or three faces. Under models, you can find our face detection model, the bin file, and the XML. I've showed you in the previous video how to observe the model using Natron, but you can see here the text, first input layer, and I'm going to run the notebook step by step. First step is to import all the libraries we need. CV2 is OpenCV and will help us with image processing operations. Matplotlib will help us plot the images. We need NumPy as the image is treated as a NumPy array. And OpenVINO is here. As you can see, it is imported as a Python package. Now we read the model and we compile it to run on a CPU. We would like to feed the image to the model, so we are taking the input and output dimensions of the model from the model. As you can see, input and outputs are properties of the model. Input layer is here, and it corresponds to the model sizes we saw on Natron. We will adjust the input image to fit into these sizes, and the output layer is also here. This is the result of the inference. And you can find the description of each of the input and output in the model description. Now that we have the model, let's load the input image. As you can see, this is an HD image, so we will need to downsize it to the input sizes required by the neural network. And we need to arrange the order of the channels. At the end of these computer vision operations of resize and reorder, we are ready with the right input tensor. And here is the inference. We are using the compiled model on the input image, and from the result, we are taking the output layer into boxes. I called it boxes because each line of the matrix represents one detected face, one box. As you can see, the model will anyway detect 200 potential faces in the image. It was trained to do so, even if there is only one face in the image. Each candidate face is one line, a vector of 7 elements. You can ignore the first two, the image ID and the label, but the third element is the confidence level. So you can see here that the model is pretty confident that the first box is actually a face with a confidence of 95%. But the second face confidence is only 5% and going down. The last four elements of each vector are the coordinates of the bounding box around the detected face, the XY coordinates of the left upper corner and the X and Y of the opposite corner. Since many of the boxes are of very low confidence level, we're not interested in them. So we define a threshold. Here I used 0.3, 30%, but you can of course try other numbers. And we keep only the boxes with confidence level higher than that thresholds. So now we have the coordinates of the detected faces, but they are all scaled down from the original image, as the inference is done on a small image. So we need to scale them up again if we want to present the bounding boxes on the original image. And here we are actually drawing the boxes over the faces. This is all. As you've just seen, using just few lines of code, you can build a full face detection application. Try it yourself. Run Jupyter Notebook 4. Load the image, load the two faces or three faces images, load your own image, play with the threshold and see what happens. We'll see the solution in the next video and we'll add some emotions to the story. See you there.